Think you know C sharp inside and out? Then this video might just prove you wrong. Today I'm going to show you 10 powerful C sharp tricks that most developers don't even realize exist. Tricks that will save you time, make your code cleaner, and maybe even impress your team. Okay, let's start simple but powerful. Null checks everywhere can be really annoying. I think most of us write it like this. But here's a little trick to simplify this expression. You can do this with the null-coalescing operator. The benefit of this is that there's less code, it's easier to read, and it's also less error-prone. Let's move on to trick 9. A lot of people still use the classic switch expression like this. But there's a modern and often better way. Let's again have a look at the benefits of this version. The code is more concise and easier to read. The compiler checks if all cases are covered, making your code safer. And with pattern matching, it becomes really powerful for types and conditions. This brings us to trick number 8, pattern matching with is. Here's how you often see it written in older code. Now, let's look at the modern way with pattern matching. This is a super clean way to work with types in modern C#. So, why is this version better? First, you don't need to cast manually. The compiler handles it for you. It's also cleaner and safer. The variable is strongly typed inside the block. No chance of an invalid cast. And it's more expressive. It almost reads like natural language. If object is string message. So whenever you need to check a type, don't write extra casts. Use pattern matching with is. It makes your code shorter, safer, and easier to read. Let's move on to trick 7, the using declaration. Here's the classic way to work with a stream reader, for example. It works perfectly, but notice the extra braces and the indentation. For multiple disposables, this can get messy very quickly. Therefore, I would recommend this version with the using declaration. This is much cleaner, no extra braces. The reader is automatically disposed at the end of the scope. So, why is this version better? First, it reduces boilerplate. No extra braces or indentation are needed. It also keeps the code cleaner and easier to read while still automatically disposing the object. And when you have multiple disposables, you can declare them in a row without nested blocks, keeping your code flat and readable. The next trick I'll show you doesn't really have any advantages, but in my opinion, it looks very cool. And maybe you can impress your team or your teacher with this one. It's called the index operator. Normally, if you want to get the last value of an array, you write it like this. But here's the cool version that I want to show you. So, if you also like this version, you can use it from now on. Let's move on to trick number 5, the range operator. It's used to take a specific number of elements from an array. You write it like this, but you have to be a little careful there. If the length of the array is smaller than the length you want to extract, an exception will be thrown. So I recommend checking the length first before writing this command. Let's move on to the next trick. It's called interpolated verbatim strings. This was made to make working with file paths and text much easier. Here's the old way without this feature. It works, but notice how you have to escape every single backslash. It's messy and harder to read. Now, here's the cleaner version with an interpolated verbatim string. So, let's have a closer look at the benefits of this version. First, you don't have to escape backslashes anymore. You can just write them exactly as they are, which makes paths much easier to handle. And second, it's much easier to read. The string in your code looks almost identical to the actual file path. So it's instantly clear what it represents. The next trick I'll show you is called discards. This is super useful when you don't care about a value that a method returns. Let me explain it with an example. Here, we're creating a variable called number that we never actually use. That's unnecessary. We can solve this problem using a discard. The underscore tells the compiler, I don't need this value. Let's move on to trick number two, target typed new expressions. It's a small change that makes object creation much cleaner. Here's the classic way to create a list. It works perfectly, but notice how you have to repeat the type list string on both sides. It's redundant. Now, here's the modern approach. With a target type new, that's much cleaner. The compiler already knows the type from the left-hand side, so you don't have to repeat it. And now, finally, trick number one. It's one of my personal favorites, the LINQ expressions. LINQ can make your collections much easier to work with, and your code more concise. Here's the old school way to get even numbers from a list. It works, but it's verbose, and you have to manually write a loop. Now, let's do it the LINQ way. You see, that's much shorter, cleaner, and easier to read. We filter and collect the results in one line. And that's it. Let's make a quick recap. We covered null coalescing, switch expressions, pattern matching, using declarations, the index and the range operator, interpolated verbatim strings, discards, target typed new expressions, and LINQ. Which trick was your favorite? Or did I miss one of your hidden gems? Let me know in the comments. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe for more programming tips, and hit the bell so you don't miss future C# deep dives.